This new phase will officially begin with the 12th flight. The pressing questions currently concern the timing of this flight and its purpose. However, recent communications from SpaceX and Musk, combined with observable progress in several key vehicles and systems, may already provide some insight. So, when is Flight 12 expected to launch? Will it happen this year, or will it be delayed until next year? Furthermore, how crucial is this mission to the future of Starship? Let's discuss it all in today's episode of NR Studio. Flight 11 marks the end of a crucial chapter in SpaceX's Starship initiative. It was the final operation to use the second-generation systems, which included Starship V2, Booster V1, Raptor 2 engines, and the original Launchpad 1. Each component was vital to Starship's transformation, but its termination marks the arrival of something even more advanced. The next generation, consisting of Starship V3, Raptor 3, and the new Launchpad 2, will set the standard for future development, starting with Flight 12. The main question now is the launch date for Flight 12. There has been discussion of two potential timeframes, one towards the end of this year and the other early next year, with hopes for a 2025 debut. During the live stream of Flight 10, Musk indicated that the V3 system is expected to be operational through 2025 and 2026, suggesting that the first launch could occur before the end of this year. Shotwell's comments also suggest a similar timeframe, lending additional credibility to the late 2025 launch target. If SpaceX maintains its current trajectory, the company has about 2 months to prepare for Flight 12 in late December, a timeframe well within its capabilities. It would be a shame to let this momentum slip, especially after the achievement of Flight 11. In terms of progress, development of key systems appears to be proceeding steadily. On the spacecraft side, the next Super Heavy booster, designated D-18, is nearing completion. The forward section was recently transported to Megabay so that the stacking process will begin soon. This forward section is not expected to be the same as the test tank segment that was moved back in September, indicating that B-18 is now entering the final assembly phase. If stacking goes according to plan, B-18 will likely be shipped to the Massey test site for cryogenic assessment in the second half of this month. This process is likely to proceed smoothly as the cryogenic testing equipment has been equipped with quick disconnect units. Following this, the booster will receive its entire Raptor 3 engine assembly and await Pad 2's readiness for static firing tests. Simultaneously, development of the next Starship vehicle, S-39, is also accelerating. After a significant delay, the first critical section of S-39 was recently shipped to Megabay 2 for stacking. Additional components are expected to arrive in the coming weeks. Based on previous construction schedules from the V2 period, SpaceX typically takes about 6 weeks to complete the vehicle's complete assembly.
If this rate persists, we could potentially have a complete S-39 prototype by mid-November. If everything proceeds as anticipated, cryogenic testing might commence by the month's conclusion. Additionally, the ship's cryogenic testing apparatus has been fitted with its own QD setup at Massey, which will facilitate testing once the vehicle is prepared. After completing the cryogenic tests, the craft will head back to Massey for engine placement, leading to static fire testing in early December. Should these processes stay on track, a launch opportunity in the latter part of December appears plausible. Naturally, all these developments are significantly dependent on the state of the ground systems. For instance, the static fire evaluation for B-18 cannot take place until Pad 2 is entirely ready. Currently, smaller setups are still being finalized. To date, Pad 2 has only experienced basic testing with the chopsticks and the water deluge system in the flame trench. In the upcoming weeks, the facility will need to conduct more stringent and comprehensive evaluations, including a full thrust simulation before B-18 can be integrated for testing. If SpaceX can wrap up these tasks by early November, static fire trials could occur in the first half of the month, maintaining the overall schedule. Regarding the vessel, one of the primary obstacles is the repair of the static fire stand, which sustained extensive damage following the S-36 test. It is essential to reconstruct this platform, which must be ready by the end of November at the latest for S-39's testing in early December. If SpaceX continues to progress at its current rate, it remains feasible to stick to the December launch timetable. Considering everything, there is a decent opportunity that Flight 12, marking the inaugural flight of the Starship V3 era, might take off before the year's end. However, there is also the chance of minor setbacks, particularly if the ground systems need extra time for verification. In that scenario, the mission could easily be postponed to January without significantly affecting the larger development timetable. Regardless, Flight 12 will signify a pivotal achievement for SpaceX. It will herald the advent of a new phase in Starship technology, featuring enhanced engines, a more robust booster, and an entirely overhauled launch pad. Every action taken now is paving the way for a fresh era of swift advancements. So, what are your thoughts? Do you believe SpaceX will succeed in launching the first V3 flight before the year concludes? Share your opinions in the comment section below. And if you're feeling adventurous, make your best guess for the specific launch date of this landmark mission. No matter when it occurs, Flight 12 will be one of the most crucial landmarks in SpaceX's future plans. Based on the details disclosed thus far, the upcoming test flight of Starship will not aim for orbital reach or execute a catching maneuver. This choice is sensible, since it marks the inaugural flight of the V3 model, and setting overly complicated goals at this initial phase would introduce unwarranted risks. In essence, Flight 12 will replicate the operational sequence of Flights 10 and 11, but will incorporate the entirely new V3 components. This aspect alone represents a significant advancement for the Starship initiative. The modifications made to the Super Heavy booster are notably substantial. Every primary subsystem has undergone enhancements or redesigns. Among the most significant advancements are the newly configured hot staging setup, revamped grid fins, bolstered catching points, the introduction of Raptor 3 engines, and a novel fuel transfer framework. These enhancements are projected to transform the performance of the booster during its ascent and recovery phases. For example, the new hot staging technique is expected to yield improved separation efficacy and greater reliability by removing the previous need for the jettison process. The Raptor 3 engines will deliver increased thrust and enhanced dependability due to their streamlined design and optimized production methods. The grid fins, now altered in both quantity and design, are anticipated to provide superior aerodynamic control, specifically throughout descent and landing phases. Their incorporation with the updated catching points will likewise enhance accuracy and stability during recovery efforts. Meanwhile, the spacecraft will showcase a smaller yet significant array of upgrades. The heat shield, an area of concern in recent flights, is anticipated to receive improvements both in material choices and installation processes, which will enhance its ability to endure re-entry conditions. Enhancements to the payload compartment and dispenser mechanism will allow them to better accommodate actual payloads in forthcoming missions. The catching points will be reinforced and redesigned in anticipation for future recovery experiments. Additionally, this iteration will feature new refueling apparatus that will facilitate in-orbit refilling tests. Naturally, this flight will also collect validation data for the Raptor 3 engines situated on the upper stage. By maintaining a mission profile akin to earlier flights, SpaceX can concentrate solely on assessing these upgrades without introducing unnecessary complications. This will assist the team in determining the performance of the new hardware in realistic flight circumstances while reducing external influences. The success of Flight 12 is vital for several reasons. Firstly, it will have a direct impact on the timeline for future flights. Any significant technical challenges could postpone subsequent missions, whereas a successful outcome would enable SpaceX to quicken its testing schedule. This would pave the way for more ambitious missions, including those involving orbital refueling or actual payload deployment as early as the following year. Secondly, the results of Flight 12 will define the goals for ensuing missions. If this flight goes smoothly, SpaceX could target orbit and even attempt to catch the spacecraft during the 13th flight. On the other hand, if complications arise, another test flight may be necessary to ensure the functionality of the new systems. In any case, the 12th flight will determine SpaceX's pace toward full reusability and orbital missions with Starship V3. Beyond its technical significance, the 12th flight also has broader implications for SpaceX's long-term aspirations. That's all for today's episode. See you in the next time.